This is the Huxtable engine as I received it. The fire goes under here and heats the air that's inside here. And then that air in turn cools off of this section. Some of the heat is transferred to this aluminum casting. So the longer this runs, the hotter this gets, and that tends to slow down the engine. So I wanted to add some additional cooling fins on here, hopefully to increase the efficiency and the runtime. I'm trying to make some fins for the Huxtable hot air engine. This is 0.025 aluminum sheet, and I made a template on the 3D printer. Just use a Sharpie to do the outside and inside diameter, and this makes the hole a bit too small and the outside diameter a bit too large. I don't have a way of drilling this accurately. So I have a starter hole, and I'm going to use a rotary file to grind that out of there, and then we'll fine tune it with a rotary stone. I'm just going to use a couple of rotary stones to clean this hole up, make it a little larger in diameter so it will fit on this. Just want it to fit on here, just like that. Nice, tight fit. I'm just using an old number 11 X-Acto blade. Come across here and just scratch this. Do it repeatedly. Usually the blade will follow the scratch. Not always. Always forget if this is a left or right hand snips, aircraft or sheet metal shears. And it curves the metal down away from the good part. We want this to stay flat. I'm just cutting outside of the line. Leave the line. And I'll chuck this up on the lathe and true it up. Now it's time to take the discs, put them on this adapter, and then clamp it down with this cap. This is a 4mm thread, and this is threaded on the 3D printer. I want to carefully take off very light cuts, and we'll take one of these off and we'll see when it's the right size to just fit inside this fixture. is perfect. It just snaps in there. Zero play. Check the next one. They should all be the same. I'm turning four at a time, and I have 16 of these to do. That's perfect. Now I take one at a time, and I get the burrs off the edges. Turn it over and do the other side. That's a nice smooth edge. We just need to do that 16 more times. This will thread onto a 5/16 18 thread. You can put it in a lathe or a drill press. And try to sand down the ridges that are on this outside surface. In order to make the fins for the hot air engine, I wanted to roll this edge inwards and make a flange on it. So when it slides on that brass tube, it stabilizes itself and spaces itself between the next fin. Taking a page out of Myford Boy's video, he made farming dies net by casting them out of aluminum and machining them. I printed mine on the 3D printer. There's just a little bit of a radius there. And I put some white lithium grease on there. Why white lithium grease? Because I had a tube of it in the shop. And this has a little lip on it right here. And this blank centers itself in there. And then you put this ring on top and tighten it down. Make sure that's still centered. And I go around and I snug these all up by hand. Put just a little grease on this edge. I've made these plugs different sizes. This plug happens to go with this one, and I want a little grease on the outside of this. Then I use this press to push that through there. There's another spacer ring that gives me a little more clearance here. And what I have found is if I get too carried away, try to do it too fast, I'll end up splitting this flange. And so that's a reject. I want that flange to form nice and even all the way around. And then I intend to put this on the lathe and clean this edge up so that all of them are exactly the same. I do the first part of this flange on this die. This next die is just a little bit bigger. And I use two more, I call version 2, and then the final one is version 2.6. And that has given me a very nice flange to go on the engine. I want to make sure there's a nice coat of grease all the way around on that plug, because this is the most aggressive forming is on the first one. Thank you. I take my time pushing this down through there. It's now all the way through. And I take another spacer. I push that all the way through. I look at my flange, and so far the flange looks good. So now I'm going to take it out of this base, and I'm going to put it in this one, and we're going to use the next two plugs. Now this plug takes it a little bit further, and then the third plug, which is this one, will take it to the final diameter. One thing I didn't mention is that these are printed at 100% infill. The plug is printed at 100% infill as well. I put that in there. This makes the inside diameter a little bit bigger. I just punch it all the way through, and I don't have to fight it out of there. The third one, and again, the reason I'm doing this in three stages is I found that if I do it in one stage, I end up with a split flange. And you do want to keep everything greased. Get that snap out of there. So that aluminum relaxes a little bit after that plug goes through. Wipe it off. And that flange seems to be okay. Take this, wipe it off. And that's a nice flange. There's no splits or anything. The files for the base, the clamping ring, the plugs, and the two fixtures that I use on my lathe will all be on Thingiverse under my name.